So today, or for this video, we're going to talk about sync vars and RPC calls. So we've talked about how to get commands to the server. Now we want to get information back from the server, because the server is the only thing that can change a game state. So I modified our bad network example a little bit, which is actually no longer a bad network example. I've added a public int HP equals 10. And then down here, I did a quick onGUI function. I would actually not recommend using onGUI, but for something quick and dirty, I'm going to say if it's the local player, I want to print our HP, and I want to print it in the top left corner. So 0, 0, and then 64 by 64, that gives me my rectangle for the label, and then HP.toString is what I want to print. So I want to print it out to the top of the screen. And now here's a common situation that you might run into. Here I'm going to say, okay, if is server, because I know I only want to change a game state if it's a server. So on collision C, if it is a server, if c.gameObject.tag is equal to another player, which we're going to set in a minute, then I want to subtract one from HP. Again, pause the video if I'm going too fast. But this is all I've modified so far. All right, now, going back to our game, if I run it, so you see my character appears, and I have my HP displaying in top left like I would expect. And here, if I go LAN client C, then I click it. And then here, it's hard to see, but there's actually a 10 there. Now, this is actually a common scenario that happened. Notice that this went down, this did not. Maybe that's because this was spawned on top of it. So if I'm the client and I run into it, then I should see my HP go down, but my HP is not going down. However, it is on this screen. Also, if I click on the server and I expand and look at my two network players, you should see, because I didn't make it public, did I? No, they made it public. Yeah, I did. Okay, so you should see that both actually have 8 HP and not 10. So here's another issue that's happening, is that for the server is updating correctly, but it's not updating the client. So now we have a desynchronization in variables. The way you used to have to do this was with an RPC call. So if I go back to my function here, at this point I can make an RPC call, which stands for remote procedure call. I use client RPC, and if I remember correctly, it has to start with RPC, just like command does. And here, what I, RPCs and commands, for that matter, have to be void, by the way. And here, I can pass in parameters, so I can pass in how much damage and take. So here I can say HP minus equal damage. And this should only run on the client side. So after the server has subtracted one from my health, I then can call my clients, RPC call. And send it one damage. Now this may, because this is a host and not just a server, this may subtract two on the server, because the server is going to be getting this one. So I'm going to comment this out. It shouldn't though. Let me just try it real quick. So this is how you used to have to do it. And you can still do this. So say you want to have like a particle effect on all the clients, but you don't necessarily care that all the particles are in the same spot. Then you can just call this function, have them start a particle effect or some sort of UI or special effect that doesn't actually affect the game state. So here we'll just file build and run. And run this LAN host and play and LAN connect. So yeah, so it did subtract 2 because this is a host. But if you look over here, this is 9. So now if I move right, move left, now it's 8. This one again subtracted 2. So if I wanted to fix this, I could just go here and comment out this. I don't need this line because this is actually a host or a server and a client for the host. But now you'll see that it is synchronizing and the values are accurate and synchronized across both client and server. So that can be kind of tedious though. This is how you used to have to do it in Unity 4.5. But there's actually a better way for variables now. So instead of doing, again, you can still use RPC calls, but RPC calls are meant for something more than just variables. It's if, you know, say you want to start something or activate something on the client side, that's when you'd use an RPC call. But instead, what we can do to make it even easier for us is make this a sync var. And a sync var is a fancy way of telling Unity that, hey, this is going to be synchronized across the network. Make sure all the clients update when this updates. Word of warning, once I make this a sync var, only the server can change this variable. So now if I run it again, both of them are 9. I move, I can one of them click, and both will be 8 again. 7. If I do it on the server side, 6. And if I check my data or my data here, you'll see that the HP is in fact 6. So 6 for this one. And 6 for this one. So now we understand what's happening here. Now also make sure you update your tag for your player object in case it's not working for you. You can click on the player prefab and make sure that you have this set to player. That's the other thing you have to do. So this is an easy way to get variables to be synced. Only certain variables can be synchronized. Arrays, list cannot. But floats, primitives, game objects, some game objects can be synchronized. Another word of warning, the synchronization is not instantaneous. So if I synchronize across a variable across a network, it may take a couple, like even up to half a second for it to get to all the clients. But it will synchronize eventually and your game will keep its synchronicity. Anyway. And then next lecture we'll be talking about how to control some AI and, you know, just instances that are only running on the server. And that will conclude the first set of, you know, the very simple introduction to networking Unity.